trying to tell you. No, real niggas know, real fans know, ain't nobody know who the fuck Scottie Pippen is. 33, nigga. He basically was wearing Kareem number. Kareem is 33. I don't know this 33, nigga. I don't know who that Bulls nigga was. I know 23, but I don't know 33, nigga. Not on the Bulls.
He's only right. He they put a statue of this dude out. I'm like, like, dude, what is that statue of this dude for? It's like, what did he accomplish?
All Jordan. All off of Jordan, man.
That's what I'm saying.
Right. He got a shoe deal because of Mike. He got everything because of Mike. And here it is, 25 years later, and he's still mad trying to get a job off Mike. I'm like, Mike wouldn't give me a job. He got a big book talking about Michael Jordan ain't give me a job.
Like, bro, you ain't get your own stuff. He gave you the platform, everything, the center.
And then the story, I'm like, well, damn, let me hear what he said. The story ain't had nothing to do with him. The coach didn't hire him. I think Larry Brown was the coach. And he said,
this nigga here was put on the dream team, a historical team.
Man, that shit make me
nervous, dog. Over real ball.
Over Dominique Wilkins, dog.
I was more. I know. Cena, y'all. I know y'all was like Isaiah Thomas. I was too, but I was feeling some type of way for Dominique. I was like, man,
oh yeah, I was. No. I was 100%. I was like, Scottie Pippen need to be at home. What the hell he doing there?
Dog, do you know niggas in the South were pissed off, nigga? Cause we all watched Dominique. Cause you gotta remember it wasn't no magic.
Yeah, somebody's like, Dominique was hurt at the time. I'm like, dog, by the time when they made the selection, Dominique was hurt.
Exactly.
He would have been ready to play by the time they did the dream team. They made the selection a year before it was time.
Man, Magic and Bird were old. Bird was hurt.
Right. That's what I'm saying. Bird was Magic wasn't even in playing. Magic wasn't even in the league.
Right. Magic wasn't even in the league, exactly. So that's what I'm saying. Like, dude, this was before the Magic or the Heat was around. We all watched Dominique. That was our Jordan of the South. We watched Dominique all the time come and drop about motherfucking 30s and 40s on niggas, 50s, nigga. Dominique was a monster. Hey, y'all want to put this sorry? They put this sorry ass bitch named Pippen in there, man. I was done. Y'all let this bum ass nigga on the dream team. Like, come on.
Oh, any team. I mean, my thing is about Scottie, and I always say this: name a game where he saved Michael Jordan. Like, Scottie Pippen stepped up and saved Michael Jordan on the team.
Playoff. I think Mike had stunk it up one time. He had maybe went to like 2 for 10, not 2 for 10, maybe like he went 2 for 10 out there. And I think Scotty may have had like 30, 33.
I don't never recall that. So even if Mike is 2 for 10, if Mike is 2 for 10 in the game, he gonna end up with 37. So I'm gonna.
Right. Sound like the first half stats.
Yeah, like first half, Mike would have them stats where he'll have an off night, then he'll come back second half and just blow you off the water with 30, nigga. So nah.
That's what I'm saying. Scotty don't have no definitive game in which all the game that he wanna show is when he dunk on Patrick Ewing.
And he didn't even dominate that game, really.
No.
And after that, he was quiet as hell. Nobody saw him again. We had to put an APB out for him.
Yeah, they still talking about, man, remember 94 when Mike retired? I'm like, that's one season. He came back in 95 and he sucked it up. And then begging Michael Jordan to come back.
Dog, in that series against the Knicks, dog, he was choking down the stretch. Horace and BJ were hitting. Horace and Cool Coach. Coach was going off the bench. And he was keeping them in the game against the Knicks because people was stinking out the joint in the second half.
He
was missing shots. Like, he would get open mid-range shots. He missing. Like, he was just missing shots. It was like...
Scotty was never a shooter like that.
Right.
He was a line drive shooter. He shoot at the basket. He don't put no arc on his shot. It's all flat.
Well, like a Westbrook shot, like straight at the basket, not a floater.
Like that, they actually got the shoot like that and got way better than nobody ever talked about. This car, used to have that brick ass jump shot. It felt like it was all lit. This looked like. Then when he got older, this looked like it evolved. But then nigga had way better jump
shot. Oh yeah, he started shooting with an arc. Vince always shot like he shot rainbows. So Vince would shoot a high arcing shot. And let it drop.
Yeah, I always remember Vince shooting a good shot because in North Carolina, he used to shoot that bitch way up high. You'd be like, that shit ain't going in, and then why? Yeah. Like, oh, what the fuck?
I look at Vince Carter.
Vince was underrated as a player because of injuries.
Yeah, exactly. Vince got hurt. Vince got hurt a lot. Then he missed a couple like big shots in games. But
what pissed me off is when they put Scottie Pippen above Iceman Gervin. I was like, what?
Oh, no, yeah, that was this.
I looked him up in the book.
Iceman was nasty with the finger roll, and then that motherfucking shot was wet.
But I don't know. When you look at Scottie Pippen's game, it was catered towards you never seen that. I gotta give him his credit and his flowers. He was the first person we really ever seen at that height handling the ball. Like the small forwards before then weren't really handling the ball like that. I know you're gonna say
but handled the ball too. Like, that's what I'm saying. Plenty of people handle the ball. Like, Scott didn't do nothing, like, different.
All like, Barkley dribbling to score. Barkley, if he passed, the nigga weaved up.
Oscar Robinson was like that. Right, but they started hopping on Pippen's nuts because he developed a little dribble. He was able to, like, run the point a little bit and give Mike the ball in spots Mike wanted. That's all he did. Like, he didn't do nothing special.
Nothing.
He was not a point guard. A point forward was Magic Johnson, if you want to be honest. Yeah. Magic was really a point forward, if you want to be honest. He was a four. What did he play on defense? He played the four, nigga. He can play the four, he can play the five, he can play the three. But see, that's what I'm trying to say, bro. Like, dude, the positions, like I said, Jalen Rose said it best. The positions was made for you to follow the game. That's all. Like, he was a forward, dog. It's just that he can handle the ball at that size, and they put him at the point. He does what Draymond is doing to y'all now, like get the rebound and he'll run the fast break. That's what Magic used to do. And then plus, Magic could play off the ball too. He didn't have to have it in his hands. So Scotty had to learn how to dribble. Scotty's thing was he was losing the ball all the time because Doug Collins was lighting fire under his bitch ass because he knew he was a bitch. Mm-hmm. So then once he developed his dribble and shit and knew how to pass and he got these long ass arms that touch the floor, like John Sally talks about it, like the guy's skilled, like for his size he was skilled, but he lacked that inner toughness that could take him like a Kevin Durant, like or Grant Hill. That's what he lacked, was that dog.
Mm-hmm.
So he wasn't he was nothing special. He just was good for their offense because he was able to see over everybody. And he could get Michael the ball and Horace the ball wherever the fuck they wanted it at. Mm-hmm. But other than that, nigga, he was just a solid role player. That's it. He wasn't all-star player. Like, he was only an all-star because Mike kept hyping him up. That was it. If Mike didn't hype him up, you wouldn't have known shit about Scotty. Scotty would have been another nigga on the Bulls, nigga, giving Mike the ball. That's it.
Yep.
That's all he was, bro. Like, I understand you want to give him his flowers because they love to bring him up in these arguments saying, Mike, look, I'm telling you, this nigga was like the 10th nigga really on the bench if it weren't for Mike. Mike made that
y'all
nigga.
Y'all don't discredit his, like,
No, he played defense. I mean, he played defense, but it wasn't no lockdown defense. And then it was a he was good at guarding the point guards. He knew how to guard the point guards because of his length. But as far as guys like the small forwards, like Derek McKee and Mashburn and them, their eyes got big when they saw Scottie. They said, oh, I'm finna light this nigga up.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Like, he was good at guarding the smaller guys. Because if you watch, because if you watch him against Reggie Miller, Reggie used to torch his ass. So Mike would have to end up guarding Reggie at the end of the game. Because Scottie was getting torched.
Because, like, think about how Reggie Miller plays, though. Reggie Miller is running like Steph Curry before we knew Steph Curry. All different off-ball fucking three. That is entirely.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I understand.
The same thing with Penny Hardaway. Penny would give him business and Mike would be like, let me get him.
But okay, I can go to another guy, Penny Hardaway. What's the excuse on that?
I mean, Penny Hardaway, he's actually more of a facilitator than you're thinking more. So if a player is known for pass, he's almost like a Jay Kidd. But at the same time, he can finish his basket. You're at his will. It's almost like our Isaiah Thomas. What really can I do to shut him down? If I stop him from scoring,
he's a Hall of Famer, right? They say he's a superstar, right?
Okay,
I'm just asking.
Name why you guard those players you just named. Like, these great offensive players.
But he's supposed to be a lockdown player.
No, I'm just saying you're not listening to it. I know Isaiah and Penny could go off. But when you're a defender like that, you make it tough for them. Like, if Isaiah was to drop 30, but he was going against a great defender, that would be a hard 30 for him to get. Now, if he goes against somebody like a Pippen, oh, nigga, he got 30 easy. Like, he not losing no sleep. That's what I'm telling you. Like, that's the difference. I'm not saying that I can't deal with his score. I'm not saying.
McGuire, but the other one he traded for.
Like seen over there eating that bowl, nigga. That's what AD did, nigga.
Mm-hmm.
That's the real AD, nigga. Not this pussy ass nigga in LA.
I go to work. Work was picking, bro.
Hey, I can't hate, man. I gotta eat that Raisin Bran's now too, man. It's all right.
Shit. Put those good in there. My mom's got to eat that. Right.
Nah, that was some soup. Some good old soup. Yeah. Something Scottie need to be doing.
Yeah, eating a chunky soup.
Well, he don't want no beef. That's what it sounds like.
No, he didn't. I mean, you think about it. They would put him at the three. Horace was saving his bacon so many times.
But nigga, we know that though. We know that about Shaq. We know Shaq was a big bitch too. Like, yeah,
Robert
did the same thing.
Robert Horry did the same thing.
All the hard work.
Right.
Robert Horry was the one doing all the hard work down there, nigga. Shaq was taking nights off, and then
him and Horace. I think Horace is on that team too.
Yeah, Horace was on that first championship team. Uh-huh. He was.
Yep, and him and these days to come off the bench.
Kobe goes to overtime. I always look at that like they really like. Actually, I believe the Suns could have won that game if Rick Smith was just came in the league maybe a year or two later, some shit. Maybe been a little younger because I felt like Rick Smith really gave Shaq fits. Like you watch that first quarter, I swear Rick Smith gave.
Go back to the Pacers in Orlando. When Orlando first made the playoffs, go watch that.
Oh, okay.
Rick Smith used to give that nigga that business. Like, he was 7'5". That's when he was younger.
I never realized how tall this white guy was. He was like 7'5".
Oh, no. Shaq talk about it all the time. How big country. He could never understand how big country. Vancouver Grizzlies. Mm-hmm. And big country would get him the business.
The other boy was killing their ass too. Sharif. Sharif was killing their ass too.
Mm-hmm.
Chris Webber. I love Chris Webber, but I don't think he had a chance to really get beef with Shaq like that. It's like, what can we really do to stop Shaq? Like, he proved to Kenyon Martin in the New York net. Like,
Weber is really a four. Weber is really a three and a four. He really is a four.
Correct. Exactly. He's a tweener. That's what they would call a tweener.
Zach called him down there. That was supposed to be that was meant for him to eat on him like that.
But the other players used to give him fits.
Dude,
like, why didn't give that boy Zach no fits?
I remember D-Buff went out with foul trouble, that stupid stuff they was calling him early, and then Foster came in, and he was giving Shaq problems. I was crazy. And they were giving them some BS foul calls.
Nigga Shaq was getting did by Oster tagging them, nigga. Oster tag was giving them problems, nigga. But that's why the Jazz used to beat them all the time.
I was never disappointed as I was. You don't know how mad I was, you know, when I last seen the season, like the Pistons win the championship in 04. I'm like maybe 9 years old watching this in the room, like, what the fuck is going on? I'm talking about it was a blowout when they won. Y'all get that, they host the trophy up. I'm like, bro, they came out here. We were supposed to be a showdown, this motherfucker. It's Ben Wallace taking over. What is this? Oh, Kobe double team. I'm like, they pressing him 94 feet for real? That's what y'all do in Detroit, 94 feet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, nigga, because that's the game plan. If Kobe would have went off, man, them niggas would not have had a chance. They had to shut Kobe down. They had to do everything to mess him up because they knew Shaq points weren't impactful. See, everybody thinks Shaq dropped 30 and all. His shit wasn't impactful. It was them other niggas that you were scared of, like Kobe and D-Wade.
Who was
the board
they had? No, they had Glenn Robinson. Didn't they?
Talking about Glenn Rice. Glenn Rice was nice.
He was hitting some shit that's impactful in the game, like, but they don't talk about that shot.
Because you got to stop Kobe. See, that's the thing. Kobe is the key to winning the game in the championship. Thank you. Shaq, you gonna let Shaq score. That's the whole thing. They was like, let Shaq go up and down the court and score. Cause that's gonna cause friction because they gonna eventually Kobe gonna get his shots. And that's where we gotta win.
Correct.
If Shaq score, we run immediately. Run down the court quick. Shaq ain't gonna be getting back on defense.
Exactly.
So Ben Wallace is outworking him and running up and down the court.
But an average fan watching the stat sheet, like, oh, Shaq at 34 in this. I'm like,
no, I remember that. But I remember that specific game and being in the room watching that. I'm like, bro, they really did 94 feet. They said, GP handled the ball. Rick Fox got handled this bitch up, and we're going to press you, too. So you're not just going to be able to dribble when we're double team.
Exactly.
We're
going to
press everybody around you.
Right. See, what they're doing is they making you take almost 10 seconds off the shot clock.
Correct.
So by the time you get the ball past half court, you got 14 seconds. So now you got 14 seconds to get through your offensive set. Now guys are getting in position. Shaq fighting to get to position. So by the time he get the ball, he got 6-7 seconds maybe to start making a move. So now Shaq's touching the ball. It's 6 on the clock, 7 on the clock. He starts dribbling. He can't even get in his rhythm in his set. He got to go right away. And you can time that. So that's how Ben Wallace is waiting for him to go up. Block! You know, now he don't have a lot of time to work.
Ben Wallace was giving him the work, nigga. It was beautiful to watch. I was like, get him, Ben. Fuck that bitch ass nigga up. Man, I love that disrespect, nigga. I was walking around the next day with a fro on. Like, nigga, that's what I'm talking about, nigga. Fuck them Lakers, nigga. Fuck Shaq, bitch ass. Everybody hated Shaq down here.
And then he was with the mask on. I was like, who this dude with the mask to do? Because Chauncey kept passing.
Oh, nigga, that's my
I'm
nigga.
About
real.
He's working Kobe. Kobe. He's running to a spot. Oh, working this screen. Oh, caught the ball here.
That nigga Rip was hitting that elbow shot, that mid-range shot was killing their ass.
You will never see that again in the NBA. Ain't nobody saying you were picking on ball goddamn mid-range.
Because you got all these soft-ass Euro players in this soft-ass offensive league now where it's just 2-3 all day.
Yep.
Yeah, the mid-range game was dying even back in the 2000s. Early 2000s, I think 2010-ish. We
y'all niggas falling asleep. Nah, nigga, that nigga KD been killing the mid-range this year.
Yeah, Chris Paul been doing it for years. It works, but...
Nobody talking about that. What's your boy call him? Shorty Dirty Bastard? Yeah, nobody talking about that. Ball, hey, bastard.
Man, because I'm giving this flowers. Paul. Don't work that mid-range.
I ain't giving
don't
that.
I mean, DeRozan is a mid-range shooter. You know, that's his game, mid-range. Yeah. But the thing is it has to work in a system. You got to have a system with that. Kawhi Leonard was a mid-range shooter, period. He really still is, but his game can go all the way out to the three-point line. But Kawhi Leonard is a mid-range basketball player.
He's the slowest basketball. He's the slowest player with the ball in his hand I've ever seen as small forward. I swear to God, I was watching him play the mid. I think he's playing Milwaukee or somebody.
He fast when he need to be. Now, when he's time, he'll blow right by you.
You see him this year? Not no more. That's over with. Them days over with, dog.
It ain't over with. He's just pacing himself. I mean, if you've been injured as many times as he has and you had an MCL, you got to take it easy. I ain't finna kill myself, and it ain't the playoff.
He got back. He got degenerative.
No, he got that game, man. I thought you had that game, man. What happened to 82 games, give it your all. What happened to that motto? What happened to the AI?
What you mean? Are you trying to put something on to me, or what are you talking about?
No, Kawhi came in the league doing that because he has degenerative knees.
Always saving up for the playoffs, your waist.
Like, yeah, because he's sucking it up. He ain't doing nothing, period. Kawhi, you act like Kawhi just ain't doing nothing. He just standing around or something. He play offense and defense. LeBron don't play any of that. That's why they call him the best two-way player in basketball. That's why you got that. He's known because of his claw, how he palms the ball defensively, getting steals, guarding people, the way he sets up defensively with the other players. And he don't talk. So I'm like, dog, this guy don't talk, but he seemed to be in position and know how to set the game up the way it needs to go.
But Cino, to add to that and shit, remember, that's why he dropped in the draft. Because remember, he came in the league with degenerative knees. So the Spurs used to not play him all the time. I think A-Dub's a Spurs fan, so he'll, he just dropped out. But he had degenerative knees coming in the league, so... He was always playing only like 60
games. Yeah, because Kawhi was the first game management player I've ever seen introduced to the league. I said, man, this league don't play like that. But we go criticize a lot of players for not wanting to play 8 games.
But, dog, he got degenerative knees. Nobody criticized somebody who got an ailment. Like, that's like if you got an ailment and you at the job. You can't do certain stuff. We're not going to say, man, Kyrie ain't shit. Man, you see Kyrie over here milking the clock? I'm going to be like, nigga, he has a condition, nigga. He can't do certain stuff. Like, niggas understand that. You know, niggas, LeBron is fully healthy, pays $100 million, $1 billion for his body, and he's sitting out. That's the issue that I have.
Hey, I think the Warriors sit out everybody when I went to New Orleans just like a weekend ago, like maybe like 2 weekends ago. So,
what are we talking about? Are we talking about Kawhi and LeBron, the Warriors? We got to stick to one subject and go to the next.
It's the NBA in general. So it's like you can't press one rule. We can't just have one rule. It's a principle. But not everybody following it.
But, dog, they've always sat players down, like, even back in the day. Like, if the player, they would sit them down for certain times, you know, if their body was, you know, becoming wear and tear, they overwork exerting stuff, they've always done that. They just started bringing the shit up now because we got more cameras, more media. That's what I'm trying to say.
I'm saying, you telling me back in, like, the 2010s, you didn't see too many. I saw a lot of guys playing 80, 70, 70 games plus. I saw a lot of
I know that they were, but I'm just saying, like, you would have some players that would either be hurt or they were trying to get their body back right. They would sit out a little bit. I'm not saying they would sit out, like, 30 games. Nigga, that's what you're trying to say.
30 games?
They would sit out probably like 2 or 3 games, and then they would come back and they good to go. See, so that's what I'm saying. You guys are just caught up in this narrative and this media shit. I don't get caught up into it.
It's not the narrative. It's the fact. Because, like, when you look at all the way, like, I understand you have a disease, but it's certain playoffs where people are trying to avoid injury the same way this guy's trying not to have a serious injury like Kawhi.
That happened all the time, yeah. So but I'm trying to say that always has happened. It's not just now. The media's making it like it's now, and people like Ticket and them are making it like it's now, but that shit is always going on, though. That's why I don't really pay attention to niggas like that in the media, because they're going to create their own narrative and their own story.
That makes sense. I don't know. It just seems like a lot of people, when you look at the game itself and you look at the way Kawhi plays, it is, he's not, like I always tell you, like HD, every time I tell you about a player, bro, if I don't like him, it's because the way that nigga plays is not exciting. Like, when you watch Kawhi play, you see why Bron get more praise than him. Like, bro, this nigga play hell boring, bro. I'm sorry. It's no facade. This nigga play like
LeBron played boring. What are you talking about? LeBron is the most unesthetically pleasing person to watch.
Well, we opposite. I think Kawhi plays. I love watching Kawhi play. I don't like watching Bron play.
Me? What? I agree. Like, what is there exciting to watch with Bron?
The only thing exciting about Bron is transition. Like, if he's in transition when he was young, like, that was fun to watch. But other than that, like, he didn't do nothing, like, because he can't play a half-court offense. So
when he got the half-court, they made ESPN commercials off that. Dude, he was in the half-court situation, got the pick, came off. I think Paul Pierce, the roller, off the screen. And then when he comes off,
that doesn't mean he could play half-court offense.
It was fun to watch.
He's athletic, but that doesn't mean you could play half-court offense because you're athletic. That don't mean that.
You can get by. You see Westbrook, he got by. Niggas get by.
All this dude do now is layups. That's all I'm seeing.
Right.
LeBron layup James. That's all I'm seeing.
With Kawhi, dude, Kawhi is back to the shoulder. I'm back to the basket. I'm Magic Johnson. I see my back. Every time I see Kawhi on offense, it's back to the basket.
Oh, he can cross you and go.
Nah, he don't play like Magic Johnson. He got more range than Magic had.
Of course. And Magic couldn't shoot. I still be testing it like, yo. Magic can't shoot.
Magic can shoot. He just shot when he wanted to shoot. He didn't have to shoot all the time. That won his game.
Yeah, when the Celtics pulled out on him in the finals, he was looking stupid out there. For real, you can't make this jump shot? I ain't used to shooting it. Oh, nigga, I don't want to hear that right now. That looks real stupid today. Like, I'm sorry, bro. Like, you look at certain players like Kawhi or Magic Johnson, players who couldn't shoot. Or, like, when you look at scores, you don't think of them niggas. Like, as much as Kawhi may average a 20 or 25.
So what are we talking about? Are we talking about scores or shooters? Like, shooters are, like, guys I think of as Klay and Steph. Now, scores, I think of guys like Kobe, Jordan, and KD. What are you trying to talk about?
We're going to generalize. We're not going to, because Kawhi game isn't based off shooting, it's scoring.
Kawhi's a scorer. Yeah, he's a scorer. He can shoot, but his biggest game is scoring. Like, he can score.
He's going to dribble the ball. He's going to need some dribbles. He's not trying to just catch his bitch and shoot. Like,
and he has a great post game. I love his footwork in the post.
I hate that shit. That shit is so
I love his footwork in the post. That shit is so ugly.
He has no rhythm. It has no – I don't see how niggas is fake by this.
So you don't like basketball. That's what you basically telling me is you don't like basketball.
No, I don't like that ugliness, dog. You know what I mean, Sino. That stiffness, you know, that thick dribbling, that that nigga didn't have no rhythm, ain't put no sauce on it. That shit was dry. He ain't got no seasoning.
So you want and one or you want basketball? I'm like,
that's what I'm saying. That's and one to me.
Out here, God damn it.
I don't want to see somebody out there go, oh, yeah, let me mix them. Oh, come back. I'm trying to watch the game.
Right.
You made for some A&1 stuff.
Right. That's what I'm trying to say.
Like, when you look at Kobe and Jordan in the post, they had some sauce to them. That's what brought the excitement. Like, even when Jordan was on, like, his last leg in the All-Star game in, like, 03, he gave Kobe the little like it looked nice, like nigga. That's not like I'm showing off, nigga. It's called I gotta have some rhythm to this nigga. It's a music, nigga. It's basketball. When you're dribbling, it's almost like you're playing an instrument in my mind. And you gotta have a little rhythm and switched up. Gotta have some.
I mean, Kawhi do the same thing. What are you talking about?
Man, you know, that's like, that's offbeat ass.
He said that nigga offbeat.
This nigga rock music to me, like, yo, this nigga offbeat. It's good music, but damn, dog, this ain't soul music, dog. He ain't part of it.
So who do you think have a better post game, Kawhi or KD?
KD looks way saucier in the post. He may be.
You think so?
I got Kawhi on the post.
I got Kawhi.
I got KD in the post. KD gonna mix up more people. People guard him totally different. People guard Kawhi totally different than the way they guard Kevin Durant. When they in the
KD get pushed out the post a little more than me.
Him
Kawhi don't. Kawhi keeps his spot. He's
thinner, but like,
and he's very, very, very like his core. You can tell his core is stronger than KD's. Like how he just sits down, how he waits, he's patient, then he turns and hits the fadeaway. Like it's all like one repetition.
I love KD's is better than me in this conversation. He's a better shooter than me overall. He's a better shooter. So
yeah, he's a better shooter. Yeah,
so
but
if you get him in a shorter distance range in like a post, it's unguardable because he's like 7'4".
But I have a better chance of guarding him than Kawhi in the post. Yeah. I'm just saying, you could push KD out of his spot. You can't really push Kawhi out of his spot. Kawhi's strong as hell and got a strong lower body than KD.
Oh, speaking of that, since y'all the OGs, y'all gonna have to start getting my man Zion some slight. Y'all gonna start talking about his game. I went to see the game. I promise you, you ain't gonna never see a player get up faster in the air in 2 steps than him. That man get up 48 in 2 steps. I watched it live on my eyes.
Nobody dissed him. Like, I just said if he keep his weight down, he'll be fine.
Bro, you see him in person, bro. He needs that, bro. He like young Barkley. He a young Barkley. You love Barkley, you love Zion.
Nah, he more of Larry Johnson to me. He not Barkley.
What?
I don't see Barkley.
What? You don't see that 1-2 cross? And
Barkley was, no, back. Barkley was way more skilled to me, in my opinion.
What? Zion can dribble. Zion can, like, literally dribble.
No, just because you dribble don't mean shit. And one guys can dribble, but are they more skilled than NBA players?
Nope.
But look,
what are you talking about?
I've seen this man perform out there. He can create his own baskets. Like, you on this post.
Yeah, he's a young Larry Johnson. Go watch Larry Johnson and UNLV in Charlotte. They're the same player.
LJ, I mean, they was, but LJ started to fall in love with that little 2-foot jump shot.
Right.
But then he got back problems, and that was it for him.
Yeah.
It's always the back problems. It's always the back problem that ends the NBA player career, like Larry Bird, Larry Johnson, like you just said.
No, Larry Johnson got hurt because he kept on eating bad and he wasn't taking care of himself.
Bird that too.
Got hurt. He was fixing his mom's driveway and hurt his back.
Yep.
So it's two different things. Like Bird got hurt because of that, but like Bird said, shit, if Len Bias and Reggie Lewis would have been around, he could have had 5 more years to his career.
Yep.
Len Bias is probably the saddest one.
Yeah, that was sad.
It's sad they both died too. That was the even craziest part about that one, man. But I don't know, Zeno. When you look at Larry Johnson, you compare him to Zion. It's like it's a good mixture. But I see the Barkley in him. I see. If you win, I see him live on the floor, dog. I'm sitting right behind the goal. I'm looking at this man. This man is fast as can ever be.
He's got quickness, but. We'll see what happens with his game. But, yeah, he does have quickness. Like, if he shoots the ball and he misses, he'll go right back up and get the rebound and go up real quick.
Yeah, he will. Yeah, Zion's nice, man. He's been balling, man.
Isolate on himself. Like, I promise you, them isolate. He's going to try to – he's literally going to do the same thing as Barkley. He's going to cross him over. I'm going to put you on my back.
But I want to see him develop a jump shot. Barkley developed a jump shot.
That's what I'm saying.
So I want to see what happened with that. Yeah, Barkley developed a jump shot. So by the 90s, that's when he was really. And I'm like, okay.
You gotta understand that, dog. Barkley in the post, dog, was a motherfucker, dog.
Yeah, early in his career, he would go coast to coast. He would take the ball and go coast to coast. And dunk on the whole team.
I'm talking about his post game, but he did something illegal. You can't have somebody on your back to the basket or back into my end for longer than 5 seconds. You can't have your back to him.
Yeah, because Barkley was doing that all day and living in it. He was living in the paint on niggas. Like,
yeah,
what?
Like David Stern around here. He made good decisions on the rule change. Like, yeah, get rid of that.
Man, look. Listen, I'm not going to speak ill will of the dead, but I got a lot of things I wanted to say about Stern. But I'm... I ain't like Stern was good. He was better than this faggot.
He's an old
white
man. It's just some things
I didn't like what Stern did. Like, God rest his soul. I ain't going to say it because I don't like speaking about people that's dead. Like, I like speaking when they hear it. But yeah, I got a lot of things I wanted to say about him. But he better than this faggot. I know that for a fact.
But nobody talk about Jerry Jones. They slept out on the rug.